How to reach the inbox, how to warm up IP addresses, what is the best SMTP servers, and much, much more in this email marketing Q&A session. Stay tuned and follow up with me. Okay, friends, before we start, please don't forget, subscribe to my channel now to get every new update almost every day. So let's start together and start answering your questions. You know, a couple of weeks ago, I sent you a message and I told you if you have any question about email marketing, I will create a full session answering your questions. And today, I will answer your questions. So let's start with question number one. One of my friends asked, which is better to use, an SMTP build with cPanel or an SMTP using Amazon SCS or simple email servers? Which one is the best? Before I answer this question, you have to know that I have a free course about building an SMTP server with cPanel. So I think this person has got my course, my free course, and he's asking which is better to build with cPanel or with Amazon SCS. Now, to make things simple, I will tell you, go with Amazon SCS. It's simple. You don't have to worry about anything, about warming up, about the performance, about the reputation, about inbox, has a high inbox rate, and so on. But in some cases, you can't use Amazon SCS. Like if you are working with affiliate marketing or CPA marketing and so on. Please refer to my video here, what is the best email marketing service or platform. I talked about this in detail and explained what is the best SMTP service that fits your scenario. So watch this video, I explained this in detail. You'll find the link in the description below. The second question says, how to use link locking in our emails? Just for those who don't know what is link locking, simply, if you are sending an email promoting maybe a certain offer, usually you will embed a URL, or you are going to put a URL, a link inside your message body. So sometimes if you are promoting affiliate links, or maybe your domain is blacklisted or something like that, you need to mask this link. You need to cloak this link with another URL. So we do something called link cloaking. We have some premium company that provides this service. But to make things easy for you, I create a small video on how to build a free link cloaker and use in your campaigns. I have full video about it here on my channel. You can check also if you want. So you can build your own free link cloaker and cloak your links and embed them inside your URL. The full step-by-step tutorial is here on my channel. You can review if you want. The third question says, how many days the IP address needs or to warm it up. So I think he means how many days I need to warm up my SMTP server. There's no direct question about this. This depends on your own server and your own list and your own reputation and your own scenario and so on. Also, to make things easier for you, I create a full video about warming up. You can find here on my channel. You can see that almost all these questions, I have answered them here on my channel in my email marketing playlist. So please go and check it. This is really a very important playlist where I answered and explained almost everything about email marketing, and you'll find almost all your questions and answers in that playlist. So please watch this 20 minutes video. I explained warming up in detail and give real case scenario examples. And also you'll find a template there to use to warm up your IP addresses. Now, just as a fast answer, warming up takes at least around 2 weeks to get somehow good reputation and you can start reaching inbox. Next question says, can you do a video about bulk email marketing, set up from A to Z, how to set up SMTP, how to set up email sender application, email reports, and so on? Yes, I can do. And the good news is that I'm doing it right now. I am building a full email marketing course going from scratch to be a professional email marketer. And I hope to finish it by the end of this month. So stay tuned and wait for my awesome new course. Next question says, what is the difference between email marketing and digital marketing? Simply, email marketing is part of digital marketing. When you have a service and you want to promote and market it on the digital world, like using Google SEO, like using Facebook ads, Google ads, maybe on social media, maybe using YouTube ads, using email marketing, all these stuff are digital marketing techniques, digital marketing strategies. So email marketing simply is part of digital marketing. I think the idea is so simple. Next question says, I need full configuration about SMTP and MailWiz. It's already here on my channel, friend, and in my courses. You can check them in the description below. I created full courses and videos about building SMTP, installing and configuring MailWiz, connecting together. You can check them all in the description below. Next question says, do you know any LinkedIn automatic email scraping tool? Yes, I know a paid tool. It's around $5, I think. If you want to buy this tool, just contact me privately. I will refer to the person who is selling, the owner of this tool, and you can buy it from him. I think it's around $5. Just contact me and I will send you the links. Next question says, please give some details about the option, the local validation option in my free email validator tool. Okay, in my free validation software, I have two engines, the local validation engine and the online validation engine. If you want really to understand this concept, I create a full tutorial on how to use my software. You can watch the video and I explain in detail what is the local validation and what is the online validation. Simply, the local validation will use your PC and you are required to have port 25 to validate the emails and have some more limitations than the online validation engine. When you use the online validation, you are not required to use port 25. You have some more options and more domains to validate, and you are not required to worry about your own reputation, your IP address, and going blacklisted or so on. It will be using an online service. So this is the main difference. Please refer to my email validation software tutorial. I explained this in detail. The next question is about MailWiz. He says, I want to know if I can use MailWiz in my local host on my PC and or should I have a hosting for it? In general, you can install MailWiz and configure it locally on your PC. It will work normally and it will send emails and will connect to SMTP servers and so on. But you will lose a lot of features and services in MailWiz, like the API, like when you want to build email lists and so on. So installing it locally is not a professional email marketing system. You need a VPS to build a professional email marketing system, but yes, you can host it and install it locally and run your email marketing campaigns, but you need to ensure that your PC is running, is always on. If you are scheduling emails like maybe for 2 days, 3 days, running a big campaign, you need to ensure that your PC is running and online so MailWiz can run. That's it. I think the idea is somehow simple. The second question says about G Suite. I want to know if I can change the IP address of my SMTP and how to do this. If you are using G Suite, you can configure anything related to the SMTP. This is configured by Google. You can change the IP or configure the SMTP in G Suite. Third question for this person says, I want to know if you can do some tutorials about configuring MailWiz to build transactional emails. I think this person somehow have some misconceptions. MailWiz friend is a sending application, it's an email marketing application, and it's not an SMTP service. When you talk about transactional emails, you are talking about an SMTP service. I advise you to use Amazon SCS, Spark Post, and Mailgun, and so on. If you are talking about configuring transactional emails in MailWiz, so to send your customers and so on, I think it's simple. If you go to MailWiz configuration, there is a tab for transactional emails where you can set your SMTP service there. The next question where we are says, my situation is that I want to start bulk mailing business. I want to know what is the best SMTP servers, where can I find email lists and buy them, general advice, and so on. I advise you not to buy email lists and start sending bulk and spam emails. But anyway, I have on my website a full article. I wrote a full article under the name Email Marketing Startup Guide. I explained everything in detail for beginners. You can understand what is SMTP, what is an email marketing application, how to connect together, how to build your own system, what is the different types of email marketers, and so on. It's really very important article to start with if you are a beginner. I will attach the link in the description below. Go and read it. I think you'll find the exact answer for your questions. Next question says, how to improve my sending score and my sending reputation? When we talk about sending score, if you want to get 10 over 10 as sending score, you have to set up SPF, DKIM, DMARC, and reverse DNS and ensure you are not blacklisted. I explained this in detail in my full course, how to set up an SMTP server and get 10 over 10 as sending score. You can review the course if you want. Now about reputation, it depends on warming up your server. If you want high sending reputation, you need to warm up your server. It's somehow similar to the first questions. You can refer to my warming up full guide to understand how to warm up your server, the factors of reputation, and how to get high reputation. You can check the video in the description below. Next question is talking about my super email free validator. And it says that sometimes I export the list and it's empty and so on. Yes, friends, sorry about this. It's a small bug in the application. I'm trying to solve it. And I explained this bug in my website. I will leave you a link below to understand and how to fix this problem by yourself for now. And in the next version, I promise you to fix this problem automatically in the application. Next question says, I set up a Windows Server SMTP following your lectures. I want to know how to send bulk emails. I can do this with Thunderbird or Outlook. Does it allow me to send up to 500 subscribers? So you need to understand how we can send bulk emails using the SMTP server. When you build an SMTP, this SMTP is responsible for sending emails. Now the second part of the system must be the email sending application, the email marketing application, which you connect to the SMTP server, and then you can start configuring and sending email marketing campaigns, monitoring open rates, and building email lists, and so on. So in the email marketing system, we have two parts, the SMTP and the email application. We connect together to have the full system. Also, I explained this in detail in my email marketing startup guide, the free guide in the description below. Please refer to it. It will help you a lot. Now, in general, you need to get an email sender application like MailWiz, Mailster, like SendBlaster, MyFreeEmailSender, or any application that sends emails using an SMTP server. So you need to get that application and connect your SMTP server. Please refer to my article in the description and refer to my email marketing playlist. I explain this stuff in detail. You'll find your answers there. Next question says, I need advice how to warm up a new IP and give example plan. Also, friend, about this question about warming up, please refer to my full video about warming up. I explained it in detail, give examples, templates, and everything to help you warm up your SMTP server and your IP address. We still have maybe one question. Where it is? Here it is. Can you share some techniques to find anyone's email address for marketing purposes? Okay, friends, to find an email address for someone, you have several options. The first one and the simplest is to use a premium service that finds email. You can use services like findthat.email, like Snowvio, like Hunter, and other services to find emails for anyone in a certain company. The second option is to use search engines. You can go to a website called DuckDuckGo, which is a private search engine, and you can try this, like enter the domain name, in my case educate.com, and write the name of that person in that company. You want to find the email address and search, and then you can search the results to find the email address. This is the second method to find an email address. The third method is you can use social media like Twitter and LinkedIn to find that profile, the person's profile, and check out his email address. And by the way, you can use Twitter advanced search to search for a specific email for someone. And LinkedIn also is a really good place where you can find email addresses almost for anyone who has a LinkedIn profile. Also, you can subscribe to that person's email list. If he has an email list, you can subscribe to his email list, and whenever he sends you an email, you will get his email. Or simply you can go to his website's company and go to the contact form and send a message asking for the email address of a certain person so you can contact. So we have different methods you can use to get someone's email address. Maybe the easiest and the simplest one is to use a premium service and find anyone's email address using these services. Okay, friends, please, I really want to know your opinions about these Q&A sessions. Do you want more sessions like this? If you have any opinions, any suggestions, I will be really waiting for your comments below. Don't forget, subscribe to my channel to get every new update almost every day. See you in my next videos.